What is the meaning of zero?
Hello friends, I am the parrot. Welcome to this lesson. Children, let us see what we will learn in this video. We are going to learn what is zero. Can you tell me which is the number left if all the things starts to disappear one by one? And we will also learn how do we write zero. Today, four of Chotu's friends have come to play at his house. Now it is getting dark. So his friends are leaving his house one by one. First there were four friends. Then one went home. Now there are one, two and three friends left. Then another went to his house. Now there are one and two friends left. And then another went. Now only one friend is left. Finally, he too went home. So did you see? There are no friends left. In such a situation, what can you say about the number of Chotu's friends? Yes, not a single friend being there means that at this time, there are zero friends at his house. So by reducing the number of objects or people, what we are left finally is with the number zero. It is night and Chotu is eating halwa. His mother asked him to brush his teeth before sleeping. But Chotu does not listen and falls asleep. That same night he dreams that there are hot jalebis in front of him. But he is unable to eat because there is pain in his teeth. So let us see if Chotu was able to eat those sweets or not.
I will eat just one piece of jalebi, not much.
But what is this? All of a sudden, one of his five teeth breaks and falls down.
After breaking one of the five teeth, now how many teeth are left in your mouth, Chotu?
Children, can you also imagine now how many teeth are left in Chotu's mouth? Yes, of course. Let us count now. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Here are 4 teeth.
4 teeth, Mom. Thank God, I still have 4 teeth left. Let me taste some jalebi.
Oh no, another one of your teeth has broken.
How many teeth are left after one of the 4 teeth is broken?
Come on, let us count. 1, 2 and 3. Which means there are only 3 teeth left.
Just 3 teeth. Let me quickly eat the jalebi.
As soon as Chotu opens his mouth, another one of his 3 teeth breaks and falls.
Oh no! One more tooth has broken. Now how many teeth are left, Chotu? Come on, let's count. 1 and 2.
Now only 2 teeth are left.
Now how can you eat jalebi with 2 teeth? At least drink its syrup.
As Chotu opens his mouth, another one of his 2 teeth breaks and falls. How many teeth are left now? Yes, there is only 1 tooth left. Chotu stands up terrified. And then suddenly the only tooth in his mouth also breaks.
Chotu, one by one all your teeth have broken. So how many teeth are left in your mouth now?
0 tooth. Not a single tooth is left.
Frightened, Chotu wakes up and runs to his mother.
Mom, all my teeth have broken. Not a single one is left. 0 teeth are left. See this.
You must have had a dream, Chotu. But if you don't brush twice a day, one by one all your teeth will get spoiled and there will be 0 teeth left in your mouth.
Mom, now I will definitely brush twice a day.
So friends, did you enjoy learning about zero? So that was all for today. Let us revise what all we have learned today. When we reduce things till we do not have a single thing left, then we say we have left with zero thing. In the next video, we will look at some more examples to understand zero better. Till then, goodbye friends.
examples.
So children, in the last video you learned what is the meaning of zero. And when there is not a single object left, it is called zero. Children, in this video we will see some examples of zero, in which we will develop an understanding of objects decreasing one by one. Now Chotu has started eating fruits instead of sweets. Let's see which fruit he wants to eat today.
Mom, please give me some grapes to eat.
Pinky had eaten grapes and there are only 4 left. Have these, I will bring more later.
Okay, I have eaten 1 out of 4 grapes.
Now tell me how many grapes are left?
If I ate 1 out of 4 grapes, then now there are 1, 2 and 3. That means 3 grapes.
Let me eat 1 out of the 3 grapes. Now tell me how many grapes are left?
Out of 3, if you ate 1 grape, then 1 and 2 are left. That means 2 grapes.
Well done, Chotu.
I ate 1 out of 2 grapes. Now how many grapes are left?
So, 1 grape is left.
Well done, Mom. Now, if I eat the last remaining grape also, then how many are left?
Not a single one. That means zero.
Now, all the grapes are finished.
Did you see, friends? Chotu has developed a good understanding of zero. Chotu has created a new game with his friends. Let's see how he plays the game of zero with his mother and his sister.
Pinky, I played a game in school today. Would you like to play with me?
Wow, definitely. Let Mom also play with us.
Mother also joins.
Come on, let me show you how to play this game.
Okay.
I will spell out a number loudly. Both of you have to clap as many times. No less or no more than that number. Are you ready?
Absolutely.
5.
One clap, two claps, three claps, four claps, and five claps.
3.
One clap, two claps, and three claps.
1.
One clap.
0.
Sister and mother were about to clap, but they quickly lowered their hands.
Did you enjoy playing this game?
So children, in this example you saw that zero quantity of anything means not even one. Can you also one by one reduce the number of things to reach the number zero? Look at the number of things around you and reduce their number one by one until you reach the number zero. So children, that was all for today. In this video, we reduced the number of things one by one and understood the number zero. So see you soon in our next video. Till then, goodbye children.